verse in the sea, peace of heaven and earth, come to the table friendly. That is our ministry, to bring people to the Lord, to the table friendly. To realize always that life is a mixture of the journey of heaven and earth. And most of all, we realize today that the Blessed Mother is inspiring us always to come to the table friendly as we celebrate the solemnity of her Assumption. Let us prepare for this holy Mass, for this Eucharist, very calling to mind our sins, deeply mindful of God's mercy and compassion. I confess, Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask, Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Thank you.
Almighty ever living God, who assumed the Immaculate Virgin Mary, the mother of your Son, body and soul, into heavenly glory, grant, we pray, that always attending to the things that are above, we may merit to be sharers of her glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Christian really is the representative of holiness. Brothers and sisters, Christ is then raised to the dead. The first person knows about holiness. For since death came true, the resurrection of the dead came also true. For just as in Eden all die, so too in Christ shall all be brought to him. But each one be proper. Christ the first fruits. Then, at this time, those who belong to Christ then comes death. When he hands over the kingdom to his God and to him, when he has destroyed every sovereignty and every authority and power, for he must reign upon his own all his enemies under his feet. The last enemy to be destroyed as death. He subjected everything under his feet.
Mary set out and traveled to the hill country in haste to a town of Judah, where she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the infant hid in her womb, and Elizabeth, filled with the Holy Spirit, cried out in a loud voice and said, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And how does this happen to me, that the mother of my Lord should come to me? For at the moment the sound of your greeting reached my ears, the infant in my womb leaped for joy. Blessed are you who believe that what was spoken to you by the Lord will be fulfilled." And Mary said, "My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God, my Savior, for he has looked upon his holy servant. From this day, all generations will call me blessed. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. He has mercy on those who fear him in every generation. He has shown the strength of his arm, and has scattered the proud in their conceit. He has cast down the mighty from their thrones, and has lifted up the lowly. For he has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent away empty. He has come to the help of his servant Israel, for he has remembered his promise of mercy, the promise made to our fathers, to Abraham and his children forever." Mary remained with her about 3 months and then returned to her home. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Aspiring,
always feast. We have this beautiful set of readings. No catechesis has been called. Catechesis is what the word of God. Magisterium, all right. Magisterium, word, have a word. So we have a beautiful set of readings. First reading from the book of Revelation, second reading from the letter, first letter St. Paul to the Corinthians, and then the Gospel of Luke. So let me share a few thoughts, in fact, three thoughts on these readings to somehow recap what I said. Today's feast is a beautiful summary of all catechetical work of ministry, and so beautiful a day as a reflection to start your assembly here in Davao. The first thought, I think, comes from the first reading of the book of Revelation. A kind of a review tells us in its own way, the first reading, a framework. What is life of faith? Life of faith is a scene in the vision of the first reading, the vision. It was a great sign. Visionary. Beautiful symbolism. Great sign. A woman. Clothed with the sun, wearing stars, with the moon under her feet, and then almost contrary to the sign, great, great sign, mourning, wailing to give birth. Then switch, second paragraph, the first reading tells us, very good for young boys and girls to tell the story, you used to imagine it this way. Second sign, but not great, the first sign is sign, great sign, the second one is just a sign, another sign of a dragon, multiple heads, and seven horns. Good for a movie, scripture movie. And then as soon as it moved its tail, one third of the stars in the sky wipe out. Of Star Wars, which you brought up. And then, towards the end of the reading, the dragon was there, close to the woman, waiting for a child to be born. Is it a life of faith like that always? We have a vision of faith, always in life, there's a dragon waiting. And then when the child was born in this vision, it was snatched, taken away from the dragon, for safety, taken by God, for saving the dragon, but even the mother also was taken to a place prepared by God. What a beautiful story for catechesis. Bible story. This is the story of the vision and the book of Revelation. But to tell us, at the end of the day, in our catechetical work, to tell us, God is there in the power of His love to protect us. God will never abandon us. Shown by this first reading, of course, preparing the Blessed Mother, the child, our Savior. But in all this, the picture is, God is there. Our never abiding presence. He will never fail us. Many times in life, the greater sign is a dragon, and another sign is a life of faith. Masakot tayo sa dragon. Always, masakot tayo sa dragon. But he is the greater sign. So alluring, so powerful. And faith is the other sign. The first reading tells us, with the gift of faith, the greater sign is the abiding presence of God. The Holy Mother, the Virgin Mary will always bring us to that truth, to that reality, the ever-abiding presence of God in Jesus in our lives. At Jesum per Maria Pastimus. That is the first thought, first element. That is why in the second reading in the letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians, there's a line there, if we are careful with the dynamics, great sign of our faith in our lives. Another sign is the evil one always creeping to squares and continue in our life. The second reading tells us, if you have that,
you struggle with that, but trying to be faithful, not always successful, but faithful to the Lord in your day. And then St. Paul tells us, with that, you can be assured that the last enemy that you will conquer is death. Sin will not triumph, all letters. The way he phrases it, the last enemy we will conquer. We will go out. By this Paul, the last enemy we will conquer is death. Well, I appreciated a liturgy, a funeral liturgy, a week ago, 2 weeks ago, for a sister who died, quite young. And I told them, thank you for your beautiful liturgy and beautiful stories of dying. The sisters seemed to be happy to die, because that should be our catechesis, to be ready, to be happy to die, because we will conquer death. And classic catechesis is a product, so be afraid to die. Who would like to go to heaven? The next step. Yes. Who would like to die? I know. I would like to die. How can you go to heaven if you're afraid to die? The last enemy that we have to conquer is death, according to St. Paul. And that is a very strong statement. If we relate that to the person we need, the great sign. The great sign. Another sign, dragon, that we will conquer that. We will conquer death. But then, in the actual life, what do we have in today's liturgy? In the Gospel reading, we have Elizabeth and Mary. Mary visiting Elizabeth, the guest and the visitor. When they did allow guests of Catholic to come, that was the host, that the visitors to Pastor Icarayan festival. But in life, all catechists and students and commanders, our life is a life day-to-day encounter with one another. But those who are well-formed in the ministry of catechism, those who are catechized, those who are evangelized, would be untapped people, like the Gospel reading. When we engage, we encounter with one another, that personality is so engaging that the baby in the other one would live for joy. Very, very inspiring. Unta. Unta kung maging anta, na maging anta, mukanta, aawit kong isa, my soul glorifies the Lord. On the contrary, ang dinaman niya, makukuloy mo katagyan mo, mga patawad. Others are not inspiring or very negative. Sana, like today's beautiful scene of the visitation, we would be persons, or the product, the results of our work, would be persons who would be very inspiring to one another. That we see in each other the good news. That sana, every encounter with this soul, my soul, my spirit, magnifies the Lord. Blessed ako that I have met you, that the mother of my Savior has come to visit me. That should be, I would like to imagine, the persons that we work with our ministry of catechism. But we have the Blessed Mother who inspire us, to guide us in our ministry, and our Blessed Mother who always bring us to her Son, our Savior. And that is what we are experiencing this evening. Our Blessed Mother whose feast we are celebrating, bringing us close to Jesus, the presence of Jesus in this holy universe.
Creator of heaven and earth, of all we see and unseen, believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten,
words and prayers of prayers can be full. Grace, body, and soul to glory, Mary shines forth as a great sign of our eternal future as the Church. As pilgrims still journeying towards the heavenly kingdom, let us bring our prayer with her to God our Father as we say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those in Christ with authority may lead and guide the people in the spirit of service, and that they may promote righteousness in the governments and be zealous in eradicating evils in the societies they are sworn to serve. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who are sick in mind and body may find healing through the powerful intercession of Mary, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all of us gathered in this Eucharistic celebration, we find unity around Mary, the lowly handmaid, exalted in glory, and that we be constant in prayer and in seeking to fulfill God's plan for salvation. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have gone ahead of us, and them especially, our dead catechists, lay missionaries, religious brothers and sisters, bishops and priests, may be welcomed into the joy of God's kingdom. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord of heaven and earth, our prayers come before you with the help of our glorious Mother, the first believer called to share in the glory of her triumphant Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.
works may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice and offerings for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His creatures.
May this oblation, our tribute of homage, rise up to you, O Lord, and through the intercession of the Most Blessed Virgin Mary, whom you assume into heaven, may our hearts, aflame with the fire of love, constantly long for you. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up, O Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For today, the Virgin Mother of God was assumed into heaven as the beginning and image of your Church's coming to perfection, and a sign of sure hope and comfort to your pilgrim people. Rightly, you would not allow her to see the corruption of the tomb, since from her own body, she marvelously brought forth your incarnate Son, the author of all life. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we acclaim.
Take this, all of you, and eat of it,